Yes, ladies and gentlemen, my dear guests, a very warm welcome back and good morning from the exhibition floor of the Smarter E-Europe 2021. Today, we want to talk in this first session about storage, electrical energy storage, as a game changer for the new energy world. And before we start with four high-ranking guests, please enjoy some highlights from the exhibition floor about storage. Yes, so many innovations to see at the ES Europe 2021. And now it's time for an innovation driver and a winner of the ES Award 2021. I had the pleasure to hand this award over in July. And I'm really happy to announce that Frank Vöge is here. He is the head of sales and project management at Commeo. And Frank, you've won an award for your system. It's a modular system. It's not just one technical feature. It's a great, great system. Very warm welcome first, and then tell us a little bit about this system.
Yeah, thank you very much for the introduction. Thank you very much, first of all, to the committee to vote for this kind of new application system as a solution for the new generation of energy storage. And this award is an it's a thank you to the Commeo team who is already live right now and follow this interview. Es lohnt sich. We have to fight for the future.
Yeah. Exactly. Thank That's you. What we're all here for, right?
Yeah.
Well, tell us a little bit about your system. It's not a single product, but it's sort of a connection.
Yeah.
Tell us some more.
Yeah, because the system is based on modules. We developed our own modules, and the module is not only the battery. The module is a whole system with different type of parts in it. And therefore, we developed all of these products by ourselves in our factory. And not only we develop these things, we produce these kind of modules in our factory.
All of them?
All of
the
them.
Components, no suppliers?
Correct.
So why do you do that?
Yeah, because we believe that in case you are the supplier for these type of special energy storage systems, you have to be the owner of the system. And to be the owner is not only based on, yes, we have engineered it, because after you will produce this type of system, you have to select all single items what you need to secure the safety at least. And based on this, it's very important for us that we are the owner of the system.
So it's all in-house?
All
in-house. That's, of course, a great advantage. But you advertise the innovative and efficient thermal management of your energy storage blocks, or your energy storage blocks. Tell us a little bit about that. I mean, is there a difference between marketing and reality?
No, it's no marketing, it's reality, because we know that if you will use a battery, it heats up internally, and you have to bring out this heating. We developed and patented a new system on it, and this makes sure that you can use this type of system at least in a normal range with full power, without any climate cooling, without any ventilation. In case your starting temperature is on the level around 20 degrees. And furthermore, we developed internally a fire flame resistant filter on it, because in case that you have a disaster in the module, you have to take care about it. And our flame resistant filter protects the system at least only one block can burn and not to bring the full system.
So that was your part of the medal. Let's talk about the reactions real quick. How do people react, not only here in Munich, but also?
Yeah. First of all, we are really surprised that so many people are here on the EES. It's for us a big pleasure to be here. We see that the market is a little bit changing right now. Because in the past, the people comes only to us and say, hey, I have interest in a storage system, but I need a battery. But now they know that they have to dedicate what kind of requirements they have in this kind of storage system. And we, with our four different type of cell chemistries at least, can support to them the right, suitable, perfect fit system, and not only one fits all, because one fits all will never be secure the requirements at least. And with our systems, we have the right block for the right application.
Okay, what do you expect for the next 1.5 days of the show?
Many, many discussions, national and international. We see that the whole world has a huge interest in battery systems, because the grid stability, for example, is one of them we have to support. And with our systems, we have from 1.1 kilowatt hours up to megawatt the possibility to supply each system, internal as well as outdoor.
Great. So, by the way, usually we hand over these awards here during the show. This year it was different, as you know, so you got them per mail, I guess.
Correct.
But still, you can use this opportunity to celebrate, right?
Yeah, we do it.
All right. Then, party hard, and thank you very much. Continued success to you. Thank you very much to Frank Vöge from Commeo.
Thank you.
And see you again in about 10 seconds with my next guest. Yes, and now I have sad news for all the hardcore heavy metal fans, because AC/DC is out. It's all about DC to AC. Why is that? I don't know. SAX Power will tell me now, and I'm really happy that Bernd Spindler is with me today. By the way, another winner of the EES Award 2021. Welcome. How are you, Bernd?
Fine, thanks. I'm glad to be here.
All right. Let's talk about the storage industry in general first. What do you think? What challenges are you facing right now in these difficult times?
I think the, one of the most interesting topic at the moment is the fast changes in the battery types. Mm-hmm. So in the past we had batteries, lead acid, then there was the lithium ion battery in charge, and now the new one is the lithium iron, which is also Tesla starting to use now. In the future, we see that the race started for the next generations to get more environment friendly, to get more, need more rare earth, nickel and cobalt and so on, and to put more capacity density to the batteries. So this is a fast changing area, but the good thing is SAX Power enables all these batteries and also future batteries. We are independent of the type of battery. And what are we doing is we make directly from the battery AC. This it means that we do not need anymore an inverter. We save the weight, the space, the costs, and also we are able to use the full capacity of the whole battery. This means if one battery cell is weak, for example, we can use the whole capacity of all batteries, and this part of the battery is not a problem anymore, because we use only the battery cells which are in the best level at the moment. And so we can go, even if they have different starting points, we can take all of the things out, which is different from what is up to now in the conventional batteries. Yeah. As you remember, the crystal light chains, for example, at home, if one light was out, the whole light didn't light anymore. By us, it's others. If one battery cell is broken, we do get everything out of the other cells further on.
Okay, I think this is the innovation where you received the award for
yes.
These storage systems without inverters. Can you think about different fields where this could work in the future?
Yes. I think it works in every on the ground, in the water, in the air. Uh-huh. Everywhere where you use electric systems, stationary or mobility. And so, for example, home storages, mega storages, car batteries, and everything. Also ships. We have also questions to build for ships, batteries, and so on.
Uh-huh. You've mentioned the e-mobility, and you're also working in this field
yes.
right now. Tell us a little bit about that. Why are you doing that?
Okay, what we think about the e-mobility is changing now. In the past, it was the question if it's a financial risk to invest in an e-car. At the moment, you see, it's the opposite. It's a risk to invest in a combustion energy car. So this is changing, and the market is growing fast. And in this area, we have especially very good opportunities with our AC battery, because the charging time will be reduced to half, mm-hmm. and the range will be extended because we can use the whole capacity.
Yeah,
and the life of the battery will be longer.
So the two main issues of e-mobility right now are basically gone, right?
Will be gone, but also the capacity itself of the battery needs to be bigger in the future, and we think the density of the capacity will expand with the new technologies. And we see now the cars have a reach about 500 to 700 kilometers in optimal environment, and we think this is the future, and we want to go there. Yeah.
Uh-huh. Perfect.
We are going to go there.
Let's put a short focus on residential buildings and the opportunities of your systems there.
In residential buildings, the opportunity for our system is as well. You have also the same advantages I told already, long lifetime and so on. And there you can use a lot of your own made energy yourself. And you do not have, and if there's a blackout, you are the one where the light still
right.
it's on.
The only one, probably.
Yeah.
Okay, let's talk about the exhibition real quick. 1.5 days are over. What do you say so far?
We are a startup company. We started 2 years ago. We won this year the EES Award about
Quite our
technology. We had a good knowledge and visions. We had knowledge in heavy current and in high-speed rail lines. To build them up, and now we have our first product. We are selling our first product. We have the first customers, which our product, our storage is working. The AC battery is working at home by them, and here at the ferry we have a lot of customers who want to buy it, and also a lot of companies who want to be partner of us. So we are very glad, and it's very good and helpful for us.
Well, then, we appreciate your time, because I guess you want to go back to the booth and sign some more contracts, right?
Sure, sure.
All right, thank you
it
very much.
It was a pleasure to be here. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much to Bernd Spindler from SAX Power. And we'll be right back. And now it's time to welcome Karl Kolmsee. He is a Director of Product Portfolio Management Energy at Webasto. A very warm welcome. Yes, Webasto is a global innovative systems partner to almost all car manufacturers and is one of the 100 largest suppliers in the industry. A very warm welcome to you, Karl.
Hi, Kilian. Good morning.
You're also one of the winners, but not from this year, from last year, where I had the pleasure to hand it over, at least virtually, to you, the EES Award 2020. Tell me about the features of your award-winning technologies.
I'm glad to do that, Kilian. The most important characteristic, actually, of our battery is that it has no special features. What does it mean? It's a standard battery. And standard battery means it's specifically well for retrofitting. What is needed, you cover all the comprehensiveness of a system. So it's a battery, it's a vehicle interface, it's the cooling or the heating of the battery, and it's a battery management system. And all that for a standard, so it's very nicely fitting into many cars and vehicles.
And if we go one step further, talking about buses, commercial vehicles, and the issues in terms of they have to be overhauled, I think, 4 times during their lifetimes, how can this be solved?
I have been in the past in the management team of a bus driving company. Mm-hmm. And one of the issues really was exactly that, that the working capital is increasing and you have to do something about it. The most important bit of a bus or a construction vehicle is a chassis. So you have to find a way to retrofit the chassis. Mm-hmm. It's a huge chance, specifically in public transport, to go into electrification by retrofitting existing buses into electric buses.
How should that work? I mean, what has to be changed, therefore?
You need a retrofitter doing it, right. And they are upcoming into the market, so that's important. And you need a new drivetrain, yes. And then you need a battery system that fits into those standard situations, which is exactly what we are applying.
Okay, let's talk about other particular trends in e-mobility or battery technologies that you are interested in as a person, but also as a company representative.
Webasto is in both areas actively addressing the markets. It's batteries and charging solutions. And the most important game changer in the future is bi-directional batteries. There's very little change on the battery side, but it's a lot of changing the use cases of such vehicles. I give you 3 examples. One is construction cars. If you imagine going into the cities with a construction car that doesn't need any longer a diesel during the daytime and during its working time, it changes the CO2 footprint of those cars. Second example is agriculture, where you are in remote areas, you need somehow electrification, you need electricity, and you don't have to carry anything with you. Again, the CO2 footprint improves. And the third and largest, and we already talked about this morning, or you already talked about this morning, is mobile batteries for stationary usages. Mm-hmm.
Let's talk about the market real quick. You've told us about the advantages right now, but tell us a little bit about the impact on the market, because you called it a game changer too. What does that mean in numbers?
Today, if you imagine that already only in the European DACH region, so it's Germany, yep, Switzerland, and Austria, there are 100,000, each year, 100,000 home storage systems employed. A normal average battery in a home system is between 10 to 30 kilowatt hours size. A car battery is between 50 to 120 kilowatt hours size.
Huge.
If you imagine buses with 200 kilowatt hours, so these are, on a sudden, battery systems that are either support the household, yeah, or even support the grid. And this means it's a complete change and new business models will be built upon it.
This is the vehicle to grid topic that we already talked about yesterday, but it's you hear it everywhere here on the exhibition floor. As I said before, you're worldwide, of course, active. You know all the different markets. Which countries or which regions would you call the most innovative, the most ready in terms of e-mobility and everything that is connected to that?
It's a very interesting fact. First of all, yes, we are in China, in Europe, and in North America. We are not yet in Africa, but once e-mobility will go there, we will be there. And it's an interesting fact that size of those markets and innovation doesn't match. Mm-hmm. The biggest e-mobility market is China. And the most innovative in the e-mobility market are Norway and California. How come? The moment the energy system, the electricity grids are stressed, you need to be more innovative. You need to link mobility and the energy market. Mm-hmm. And this is exactly where we are looking at. And this will be brought from Europe and North America to China. They are starting now because we see as well in China that the energy system is more stressed after many years.
That's quite interesting. Okay, let's come back to Munich and talk about what you're experiencing here in these days.
As many of you might know, we have been at the IAA some weeks ago only, and this exposition seems to be taking more interest of many people than the IAA. So we are very glad to have many visitors at our booth. They are interested in both in batteries and charging systems, and we are glad to present how to bring those two things together.
It's great to hear. Thank you very much, Karl Kolmsee from Webasto. Continued success, and I have one more to go in a couple of seconds. See you then. Yes, this is my fourth guest of the day, and he's a representative of Enphase. To go in detail, he's the general manager for the DACH region, that means Germany, Austria, and Switzerland. Great to have you with us, Jarno Wagner. How are you today?
Hey, I'm fine. Great to be here. Thank you for the invitation.
All right, I visited you at the booth a couple of minutes ago. It was already packed. Tell us a little bit about your impressions here.
Yeah. So the impressions are amazing. So we have missed last year, no exhibition last year, so we are quite happy to be here. As a new player in the German market especially, yeah, we are worldwide active, but it's great to be here, and we have been an amazing day yesterday, so we look forward to today.
You are also one of the winners of the EES Award with your system Encharge.
Right.
Tell us a little bit about that. It was for the US market first, and now you're coming to Europe and Germany. Why is that, and what do you expect?
Yes, that's right. So we launched our Encharge system in US first, because it's our home market. We're experienced there, our headquarters based there. And we had got a really good response from the market there. And we started our activities in the German market in the beginning of last year. So in Germany, it's really important to have a storage system when you want to sell a complete system, so PV alone is not enough. Mm-hmm. And it was always clear for Enphase, we have to go to Germany, it's one of the largest storage markets in the world. And
a lot of competition also.
Yes, sure, it's there, but we are not afraid of that, because we know we have a superior technology, which is really different than others, because we really focus on simplicity, easy to service, a high performance and flexibility. And I think we bring some kind of a new spirit in, and we are happy to be here.
Mm-hmm. What are your the first reactions of this market to be here? Could you use this award-winning topic, winning the EES Award a couple of weeks ago?
Absolutely. It helped us a lot, because Enphase is a big player worldwide. We are also active in other European markets where we are very strong. And we made this step to Germany really to do the things right, let's say. Yeah, and the award helped us a lot to get attention from the market, because everybody has known Enphase as a name, but especially in Germany, people don't know yet as much as microinverters and AC technology we offer. So the award was a great thing for us.
Okay, now the sad news. It's just 1.5 days left of the Smarter E Europe 2021. What do you expect?
Yeah, I expect 1.5 great days, which we will have like yesterday. And I think then the work starts, because we accelerate really much now. We have a large team now in Germany. We go with full power. And exhibition ends, and then the work starts to visit our customers, go on site, introduce our products.
All right, thank you very much to Jarno Wagner from Enphase, and of course, continued success. All the best. Take care.
Thank you very much.
All right, well, as you can see, there's a lot of stuff going on in the storage market, in the storage segment, a lot of innovations that can be seen here in Munich. And, that's it with our sector about that. And I want to tell you that we will be live again at noon, at 12 o'clock, and then we want to talk about digitization and smart applications with more interesting and, of course, high-ranking guests. See you then. Take care.